Let us solve problem 1, theories of failure. First, let me read the question. A component made of steel has a yield stress of 353 MPa. It is subjected to direct stresses 150 Newton per mm square and 100 Newton per mm square along x and y directions and a shear stress of 50 Newton per mm square. Find the factor of safety by maximum principal stress theory and maximum shear stress theory. First, we'll write the given data. The direct stress acting along x direction is 150 Newton per mm square, and direct stress acting along y direction 100 Newton per mm square. And the shear stress acting along xy plane is 50 Newton per mm square. Also, the yield stress is given as 353 MPa for the material. So we know that 1 MPa is 1 Newton per mm square. So yield stress is 353 Newton per mm square. We need to find the factor of safety according to maximum principal stress theory and maximum shear stress theory. First, we'll take the maximum principal stress theory. We know the direct stresses. We need to find the principal stresses. To find the principal stress, we'll use the equation to find first the maximum principal stress. Sigma 1 is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus square root of sigma x plus sigma y, sigma x minus sigma y whole square by 2 plus tau square xy. Let us substitute the values here. Sigma 1 is equal to sigma x is 150, sigma y 100, plus square root of 150 minus 100 whole square by 2 plus shear stress is 50 square. So by solving the equation, we'll get the maximum principal stress as 180 Newton per mm square, which is tensile in nature. Similarly, we can find the value of minimum principal stress. If we take, instead of plus in the equation, if we take negative, we will get the minimum principal stress, that is sigma 2 is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 minus square root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square xy. Let us substitute the values. Sigma 2 is equal to 150 plus 100 by 2 minus square root of 150 minus 100 square by 2 plus tau square xy, that is 50 square. By solving this, we'll get the value of minimum principal stress, that is 69 Newton per mm square. So now we have found out this is also tensile in nature. We have found maximum principal stress, which is 180 Newton per mm square tensile, and minimum principal stress, that is 69 Newton per mm square, which is also tensile. By knowing this principal stresses, we can apply the condition of failure, that is according to maximum principal stress theory. The failure of the material occurs when the maximum principal stress equals the yield stress of the material divided by factor of safety, N. So now let us substitute the values. N is equal to sigma y by sigma 1. So sigma y is 353 and maximum principal stress is 180.9. So from this we will get a factor of safety of 1.951. So according to maximum principal stress theory, factor of safety is 1.9951. Similarly, we can find the factor of safety by maximum shear stress theory. According to maximum shear stress theory, the failure occurs when the maximum shear stress, that is tau max, reaches the value of shear stress at yield point divided by factor of safety. So to apply this, we need to find first maximum shear stress, which is equal to the difference between the principal stresses sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2 or sigma 1 minus sigma 3 by 2 or sigma 2 minus sigma 3 by 2, and largest of this value is taken for the condition. Now sigma 3 is 0, so the equations reduce to maximum shear stress equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, then sigma 3 is 0, that is sigma 1 by 2 and sigma 2 by 2. So the largest of these three values is to be taken for applying the failure condition. So then tau max is equal to sigma 1 by 2, which is the largest value of the two. So we know that the value of sigma 1 is 180.9 Newton per meter square. So the maximum shear stress value reduces to 90.45 Newton per mm square. Taking this maximum shear stress, we can compare with the yield stress of the material. So tau I is equal to, but we have to find the shear stress at yield point. So that is equal to yield stress by 2, that is 353 by 2, which is equal to, that is 353 by 2 Newton per mm square. So now we will compare the maximum shear stress with shear stress at yield point divided by factor of safety. So maximum shear stress is 90.45, which is equal to 353. That is yield stress 353 by 2 into factor of safety, that is N. So from this you will get the value of factor of safety of as 1.9. Now by comparing the two theories, according to maximum principal stress theory, factor of safety is 1.951, and according to maximum shear stress theory, factor of safety is 1.9. Let us solve one more problem on theories of failure. A circular rod of diameter 30 mm is subjected to a load of 20 kN, which is compressive in nature, and a twisting moment of 15 kN. Yield stress of the material is 328.6 MPa. Determine the factor of safety as per following theories of failure, that is maximum shear stress theory and maximum normal stress theory or maximum principal stress theory. First, let us write the given data. The diameter of the circular rod is 30 mm. It is subjected to a load of 20 kilonewtons, compressive in nature. Yield stress 328.6 megapascal, which is also equal to 328.6 newton per mm square. So load should be in newtons, 20 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons. We need to find, and also the torque is given as 1.5 kilonewton meters. Let us convert this into newtons, 10 to the power of 3, and to convert from meters to millimeters, another 10 to the power of 3. So now the value is in newton millimeters. Okay, newton millimeters. This is the data given in the problem. First, we will find the direct stress, which is equal to load by cross section area. Load is 20 into 10 to the power of 3 newtons, cross section area pi into 30 square by 4, which comes to 28.29 newton per mm square. So this is the direct stress, which is compressive in nature because the load is also compressive. Shear stress can be found out by taking the equation 16 t by pi d cube, where t is the torsional moment, 16 into 1.5 into 10 to the power of 6 newton millimeters divided by pi 30 cube. So we will get the shear stress as 282.9 newton per mm square. So once you find the direct stress and shear stress, we can find the principal stresses. So the maximum principal stress sigma 1 2 is equal to direct stress by 2 plus or minus square root of direct stress by 2 whole square plus shear stress square. Substituting the values 28.29 minus, because it is compressive stress, plus square root of minus 28.29 whole square by 2 plus shear stress is 282.9 whole square. So this works out to the value of major principal stress, that is 269.15 newton per mm square. Similarly, we can find the minimum principal stress by taking the negative sign sigma 2, and after calculation we will get the minimum principal stress as minus 297.0 newton per mm square. And sigma 3 is 0. So now with these three values, we can find the maximum principal stress. According to maximum principal stress theory, the failure of a material or a component occurs when the maximum principal stress reaches a value of yield stress of the material by factor of safety. So substituting the values in the condition, from this we'll get the value of factor of safety as 1.10. So this is according to maximum principal stress theory. Similarly, we can find the factor of safety by maximum shear stress theory. According to maximum shear stress theory, the failure of a material occurs when the maximum shear stress reaches the value of the shear stress at yield point tau y by factor of safety. So to apply this condition, first we need to find the value of maximum, the first yield stress, shear stress at yield point is equal to yield stress by 2, that is 328.9 by 2. We will get the value of 164.3 Newton per mm square. So this is the shear stress at yield point. Then maximum shear stress can be calculated by the difference of principal stresses sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, which is equal to (269.15). Since compressive stress, the minus it becomes plus, and the maximum shear stress value is 283.2. Newton per mm square. Now, sigma 1 minus sigma 3 by 2, difference between the other two principal stresses, works out to be 134.57 Newton per mm square. And the third one, sigma 2 minus sigma 3 by 2, sigma 3 is 0, so we will get minus 148.7 Newton per mm square. So out of these three, the largest value is to be considered, and it is to be compared with the shear stress at yield point. So now the yield stress, shear stress at yield point is 164 and tau max is 283.2. Equating these two, we can see that the tau max is greater than tau y. That means the maximum shear stress is greater than the yield stress. So hence the failure of the material occurs. According to maximum principal stress theory, factor of safety is 1.1, and according to maximum shear stress theory, since maximum shear stress is more than shear stress at the yield point, so failure of the material occurs. So we need not find the factor of safety in this case. So failure occurs by maximum shear stress theory, since tau max is greater than tau 1.